These appointments are a clear testimony of the trust and the confidence that the President and the Commander-in-Chief has in us to give this, to give us these noble responsibilities of now being the ones to take care of this mighty force, which is responsible for the stability of Uganda, because it's only that stability that can deliver his vision and the different programs that have been lined up to achieve that vision. So, congratulations, gentlemen. You know, one time, some few years back, specifically 2013, I was a division commander in the 4th Division. When I went around the barracks, I found a lot of panyal. I said, now, how safe are we here? So I got a pen. I know I got my division engineer. So we went around the barracks with my team of admin. That gentleman was my twice in the 4th Division that time. I say, you see here. I said, yeah, this only problem can only be sorted out by a fence around this barracks. So I said, now you come up with the BOQs. So he came up with the BOQs and of course a figure to it. So I wrote. At that time, I think I didn't even know protocol. Maybe, or I thought writing direct may help more. So I wrote the Joint Chief of Staff. But I gave Commander Land Forces a copy. I first asked him, sir, I want to write you this letter. He said, no, you write direct, but give me a copy here. I gave a copy here, and I wrote to the division commander, the Joint Chief of Staff. I think about 4 months later, was it even 4 months? Is it 2 months later? Something like that. Eh? 2 months. Uh-huh. 2 months later, I was in my division commander's house there at 8 in the evening. The signora comes knocking. Who is that? Signora. Signora, and after nini, bwana nilikuwa nimesoma sitrep ya jioni. Asema, there is a message here, sir. From where? From His Excellency the President. Ah. So I opened for him. He gave me the thing. You've been appointed the Joint Chief of Staff. Ile barua habadu jibu. So I come. What was lining up, the first thing on my desk was that letter, which I wrote when I was... So, when I look at this team, it has just been that this team has just moved through the other place. Now, what you have been writing, you are going to find it there. Because you are here as if you are still the Chief of Staff, Land Forces, Commander Land Forces. Now we are going there. But that is very good. Why? Because it means we shall appreciate the problems of these forces better, because we have all been there. Because we have all been there. So really, for me, I think it is a good team. If we don't make an improvement to what our predecessors have handed over to us, it can only be because of not working in harmony, not working as comrades, and not working as a team. But I doubt that there is anything that will prevent us from behaving that way. We take over, of course, land forces makes the bulk of our mighty force. Because that's how our doctrine is. I don't want to go into details. You know how we have prepared our fight to fight. So you are taking over this service when, as you know, we just came out of a situation of political waves which was trying our revolution. And the values for which all of you people here stand, fought for, and which has so far achieved a lot through the visionary leadership of our Commander-in-Chief and through its vision, the revolution's vision for a fundamental change for Uganda. And these achievements are visible. This fundamental change is visible. Those who say other things, I think the Bible somewhere says they have eyes, they can't see. They have ears, they can't hear. Maybe they have those problems. But they are visible. Unity and democracy, it's there. Even in the army, we vote. Tangu siku gani, hata kwa jeshi yetu ya Rwenzururu. But here, democracy and unity, I don't know, this is a jig. This one you call what, Malalot. That one is, now this one was blaming this one that he took good cows and remained with the short ones. And for you, Bakaramoja, Bachakuvanja. That's why every small thing you try to put in the pencil there, they come for it because you remove the good ones and came. Then this one disappeared. But these ones were very lucky and very wise. They went far away. Far away, so. And they made sure they feed them and they developed long horns. So when they developed long horns, when the Karamajong goes there, they say, no, this one does not belong to us. For us, we're looking for the short ones. So, democracy and unity. If you look at this team here, Nyam from the mountains is there. That man is from Kalungu eating fish from Lake Victoria. This guy is from here eating matoke. This one is from there drinking milk. Ojik is from here eating Odi. He's from the other side eating Atapa. Look. Yes. And when people talk about this force, this is the national character that we are looking for from this. We don't want to know how many O's are in this army, how many barukus, how many, no. It is merit. You heard somebody say, I have never lobbied. I too has never lobbied. Everybody here Maybe people lobby for us without us knowing, but who? So, these are the fundamental changes we are looking for. In our army, these former armies, there were people who were killing each other. The chief of staff is hunting the division commander as if he wants to be a division commander again. You know this story. So this is a fundamental achievement of unity and democracy. Peace and security is another milestone of our great leader. And this is through building a strong force. The media, they are here. They like touching on one small thing, and then they make a big cloth from that small thing and put it all over us. UPDF. UPDF is a structured force, and its first value is discipline. And we have measures in place to handle those who deviate. At least you start from there, so that you now follow to see whether the person who was found culpable has not been punished, or is not before the, has not been arraigned before the courts of law. Because for us, discipline of the UPDF is simply based on the realization or the recognition by the individual soldier or officer that deviating from the established norm has consequences, and they may not be good. And so it is not something we play around with. So, media people, please be reporting about us responsibly. If an individual does a mistake, that is him alone. And we have laws in place to handle those individuals. And this is why this peace and security has succeeded. Human rights. Those days it was human wrongs. Now it is human rights. These guys can even come into our barracks and say, we want to see you on a bus, prison. And we allow them. Because we are not hiding anything. Those things were not there at that time. Infrastructure involvement, we can all see it for ourselves. From here to Kitgum now, you take only 4 hours. From Kampala here to Kitgum. Long are those days when you would maybe spend 2 days and under escort. If you reach Karum and the convoy has left you, then you, until you, another one comes, that's when you will cross River Karuma, I mean Nile. But now, this infrastructure development, you can see, industrialization and economic development, you have been hearing the figures of where we were in 1986 up to now, wealth creation. In the last budget, we are only told that only 39% are now remaining outside the money economy.